Back up, Nima. Back.
Yo, this is not gonna be your normal type of video that you would expect from me. And I'll explain why. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano III. Y'all guys are The Third Family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed, consider becoming part of this family, clicking the subscribe button, bottom right-hand corner. Now, the reason why I said that this video is not gonna be your typical video that you would expect from me from a reaction and a breakdown is because I have mixed emotions about the release of this original version or this rough cut, this rough draft of what eventually became Bang, the official track, the official single release by Conway the Machine and Eminem. I have mixed emotions about it because this was never supposed to be released. This was never supposed to be for anybody to hear. Eminem already put out his statement saying that this is not what I wanted. This is an unnecessary distraction from everything, all the political things that are going on in the world that people need to be focusing their energy on. I'm gonna read you Eminem's official statement in response to Revolt TV on his Twitter. He said, "I agree with Revolt. This is an unnecessary distraction. I never meant for that verse to be heard. It was heated in the moment and I thought better of it and decided to pull it back. Stuff that I never intended to release continues to leak from the huge WeTransfer hack." I guess WeTransfer is a company that got hacked and Eminem's, you know, unreleased verses were on there. He says, "I don't have any issues with Revolt. I actually welcome the opportunity to work with them on some positive things and turn this into a different direction." That is Eminem's official statement on this. He never wanted this to be released. Obviously, this verse was written a long time ago and this is like he was just brainstorming and he was just dumping into rhymes onto paper and then he eventually refined it and we got the single in the way that it was intended to be released. It's not exactly on the same level, but it kind of is as to when like celebrities have their naked pictures released. That's not anything that was ever intended for the public. So it feels like dirty and it feels like you can't enjoy it because it wasn't intended for you to enjoy. I'll put it this way for y'all to understand a little bit easier. Imagine like you're taking your finals, you're in college, you're about to graduate. You need to write a 15-page final essay for this class you have to ace in order to get your diploma. The professor gives you 3 months to write the paper and finalize and present it to him or her so that way they can grade it. A month and a half in, 6 weeks in, they just come out of nowhere and just rip the paper out of your hands, your rough draft that you're trying to refine, and then they just grade that instead. You wouldn't like that on a personal level, so we should not be liking this verse or we should not be spreading this as this is what Eminem wanted. This is really what he was thinking. People say whatever the fuck they're gonna say because they're just dumping shit out of their mind. They're just brainstorming ideas. And someone who writes in the way that Eminem does, like he is not gonna hold back on what he's writing onto the paper. He's just writing to write till he sparks something, and then he refines what he's trying to do to present the final recording. For everybody on Twitter that sees that meme that goes underneath like controversial things that people say and then it like goes viral, and then the meme right underneath it is like, "You should have left this one in the drafts, bro. Like, delete this." That's pretty much what Eminem meant to do. He meant to leave this in the drafts, but somebody went into his drafts and pulled it out, and now he has to respond. Like, that's not anything that I endorse. So I'm here to tell you right now, so that way you can click away if you don't want to hear the rest of this video, I am not gonna play the actual song. I thought about playing just the verse because I already did the song. If you want to hear the actual reaction, I did the song like the day it came out. So if you want to see the actual reaction, then go watch the actual reaction. I'm not gonna play the verse because it's not something that Eminem intended for us to hear, and I wouldn't want somebody to come over here and take my raw video where I stumble and where I like mess up my words and I stutter and like all that shit is happening behind camera and I edit it out. I wouldn't want somebody to go and take it out of my drafts and like make a video for it. So I'm not gonna play the actual song. I will go over the new lyrics. That's what I plan on doing right now, and go over the double entendres and the wordplay just so people can kind of understand who don't speak English, so that way they can experience the double entendres and the homophones and the multiple meanings of different lines and different bars in the same way that people who speak English are understanding and are comprehending it. And I'm not even going to go over the entire verse because I already heard the verse, and a lot of the verse is what eventually was on the single. There was probably like 8 or 10 bars in there that were new to this version, to this unreleased version. So if you're here for the audio, you might as well click away right now. If you're here for the actual bars and you're here to like for the breakdown that I would normally do, Let's go. So where he says, I used to be a man of the people, hit the clubs and mingle, dreamed of day fucking pink like a flamingo. Like, that's nothing new. That's all on the original track. And then the cannabis, hand him his ass, Ja Rule in 02. You know, I shoved the Oscar up his wazoo. I already explained all of those on my first reaction, and all of that is still normal. That's still in the song. But right here where he says, shout out to Puffy Combs, but fuck Revolt. Y'all are like a fucked up remote. Now I get why our buttons broke. All of that is new. And that's dope ass wordplay, because he says, fuck Revolt. Revolt is obviously a media outlet, but he says, y'all are like a fucked up remote. Now I get why our buttons broke, like literally like a fucked up remote that doesn't work. The buttons are literally broken, like a remote control. And he says, cause you press him and he don't do nothing though, especially when it comes to punches thrown. Like you press him, whenever you press somebody, for people who don't know what press means, it's like whenever you put pressure on somebody to get a reaction or to get information out of them. The best example that I can get of somebody pressing somebody, whenever a defendant is on the stand and then the DA or whoever the attorney is that's against the defendant, they're trying to like press them with questions to get them to stumble and to get them to say something that they normally would not say. They put that pressure on them. So he's saying, because you press him, but he don't do nothing though. Like a fucked up remote when you press the button. So he's using press in two different ways. And he said, you motherfuckers keep wanting smoke, like you keep wanting the beef. Smoke is slang for beef, and beef is slang for like static, and static is slang for like for like wanting to have some type of lyrical fight. He says, you want the smoke? Well, I got the blunt rolled already, like literally marijuana smoke. Take another toke of the marijuana smoke, spliff and inhale, cause all you're gonna get is an L. Like on the original song and the original video, I missed that one because I'm not a smoker. And L is literally what you call a joint. Like it's like, hey, pass the L or whatever. But he's also talking about like, you're gonna take a loss if you want the smoke. If you want beef with me, you're taking that loss cause I don't ever lose. And I'll smoke you another meaning for the word smoke. So we got literally weed smoke, and then we got smoke as in beef, and then also I'll smoke you like in a race, or like I'm just gonna stomp on you, like it's gonna be an easy win for me, like a fucking roach. And then again, a roach is another type of way of smoking weed, like a roach clip, like in Cheech and Chong and like in fucking Blow. And then my favorite part of the whole unreleased portion is, and it's not because of what he's saying, it's because of the way that he uses the words and the way that he flips everything. He goes on like this 6 to 8 bar like continuation of having a common cold or being sick, like you're sick on the mic, but also we have nothing in common, like a fucking cold. Like when you go to the doctor and they say that you just have the common cold, like you need to go home and rest, drink fluids, you got the common cold. So we have nothing in common, not even a fucking cold or nasal issue if it comes to blows, bro. Like nasal issue, like your sinuses, your nasal sinuses. When it comes to blows, like literally blows, fist punches, but also blows as in like you blow your nose whenever you have a sinus infection. Yo, the wordplay. This is like my favorite part of everything. Wasted tissue, tell this journalist to stick to the stuffy nose. Bro, like stuffy nose, like stick to what, like don't be writing about shit that you don't even know what you're talking about. Stick to what you know, stick to what you're good at, but also stuffy nose. Like you have a stuffy nose and you use tissue paper and wasted tissue. I don't know if he's calling Revolt like a tissue, like a waste of paper space, as if it was old media, like a news magazine or like a newspaper, like wasted tissue. But then he says like, always running from me, go. And that Migos line I didn't get, because I don't know if there's beef with Revolt and Migos or why he's bringing Migos into it, or if he's saying like from egos, but it sounds like from Migos, like he's using the homophone talking about egos. But he says like, always running like a runny nose, and we're still on the stuffiness thing. Just shit's just fire. And then don't compare me alike. It's something comparing me, pick a fair fight. All that's already in the original song. It's just wordplay. He's not really saying anything there. It's just a lot of good rhyme scheme. And then he says, compare me to lightning, that similarity striking. That's always a good line. That's always a line that I love when I heard it originally. He's trying to capture lightning in a bottle twice on Marshall Mathers LP. Because the original lightning was the spark and like his massive success from the first three albums that he had. And then he went through like that sleeping pill addiction phase where it was kind of like rocky. And then now he's trying to find that lightning that he caught originally, catching lightning in a bottle twice. And he says, here, compare me to lightning, that similarity striking. But my favorite line out of this last portion of like this part that's on the original is when he says, compare me to Manson, Marilyn or Charles. Like Marilyn Manson, the singer who was signed to his label, I believe, back in the day. Manson isn't who you think. Like if you look at interviews, you watch interviews of Marilyn Manson, he's like a polite kid. He's got manners. He's like extremely easygoing, easy to talk to, very like, he's very soft-spoken, which is completely opposite of Marilyn Manson, the actual like act. And then Charles Manson is obviously the serial killer, but also is like seen and proven by psychologists to be a genius. And Eminem is saying, like, he's that genius with the pen, but he's also a killer with the pen, but he's also not who you think that he is, because he's not the same person on the mic that he is in person. So that line's a favorite of mine on the entire original song. And then Floss Raps trying to stunt, compare me to Meek Mill, Big Willie's get popped. That's also on the original song. We're talking about Will Smith, they're going home, fuck Nicki Minaj. All this is in the original song. There's a beat switch in the original song right here, and this is actually going toward the end of Eminem's section. So he like takes it up another notch after the original end of the song, and that's where we come to Eminem talking about Godzilla and talking about Machine Gun Kelly. And I don't know who Griselda is. Actually, you know what? Let me look her up real quick. Griselda Blanco, is that who he's talking about? Griselda Blanco, La Madrina, the Black Widow, the Cocaine Godmother, the Queen of Nautical Trafficking. Bro, those are fire ass nicknames. Imagine being nicknamed the Black Widow or La Madrina or the Cocaine Godmother. Yo, that shit's fire. I don't know if he's talking about her. That's just the person that pops up whenever you type in Griselda. But he says, I got a beast, I will unleash Godzilla. I'm assuming he was writing Godzilla. He was forming the album that just came out when he was writing this verse for Conway the Machine. I think he's literally talking about Godzilla, the song. But this right here, this wordplay right here is fucking nuts. He says, how can we be so hella? Cop the motherfucking attitude. I'm gonna need propellers, the chopper, machine gun killer. Yo. So much fucking wordplay right there. Obviously, he says Machine Gun Killer. That's wordplay on MGK's name, Machine Gun Kelly. But he says, how can we be so hella cop the motherfucking attitude? Like you cop an attitude with somebody, but also helicopter, that's the homophone for an actual helicopter. And he says, I'm gonna need propellers, the chopper. Like helicopter propellers, and then also chopper is what you call a machine gun, but also chopper is a nickname or slang for helicopter. Helicopter motherfucking attitude. Yo, that wordplay right there is fucking nuts. And then he said, gun in the machine, the similarity stopped there between Kelly and Conway. That's a bar, because Conway's name is Conway the Machine, and then Kelly's nickname is Machine Gun Kelly. That's the similarities. Everything else stops because Machine Gun Kelly's down here. Conway the Machine is up here. That's fire wordplay. To put Machine Gun Kelly down and put Conway the Machine up in the same line, shit's nuts. And he says, but fuck that little blonde bitch too, obviously talking about Machine Gun Kelly. And then he says, RIP to Mac Miller. Bro, I can't even listen to Circles. Like, I have to listen to Circles every once in a while, because then I'll start missing and get sad about Mac Miller. If you haven't been on the channel long enough, Mac Miller is an artist who I grew with him over the last like 12 years. So I was extremely connected to Mac Miller's music. That was the first celebrity death where I was like, damn, shit hit, you know what I'm saying? And then he says to end the verse, but come and get it if you think that this shit's a, and then it goes on into think this shit's a game. I mean, obviously the wordplay was fucking out of this world. Just, it's Eminem, what do you expect? This is exactly what I would expect from an Eminem verse, especially a feature verse where he has to come hard with it because it's not his song, he gets one verse. But all of that to say, I also don't think that this verse should have ever been released. So I like the verse is obviously fire, but I actually like the original verse more because I can understand how the original verse from the original song came from this right here. This sounds very unrefined. His verse just kind of ends out of nowhere. It doesn't really go right into the chorus like the original one did. There's no beat switch up like the original one. It originally switches up when he starts talking about Nicki Minaj, I believe. The original verse is the one that I would choose 100%, 10 out of 10 times compared to this. But yo, that pretty much ends today's video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking the video and leaving a comment down below. All that helps the algorithm. If you like what you see enough and the analytical breakdown of the bars, like I said, I didn't really break down as many bars as I normally would because I've already done it. If you want to see the original version of this song, just search for it in my name. Put the third Ernest at the end of whatever you search and it'll pop up. But if you like what you see enough, like I said, consider subscribing. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at the third Ernest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. Hit up the Discord. You want to talk to me, that's where you're going to do it. Also, link down in the description below. That pretty much ends today's video. I appreciate y'all's time. Like I always say at the end, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. That's normally all I say, but right now, wash your fucking hands, wear your mask, stay inside, and I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.